Have you used the new filter button in Lucas Studio to filter your report? If you are confused where to start, this video is for you. Hi, welcome back. This is SL from Danalyser. In today's video, we are going to talk about filter buttons. Filter buttons allow users to apply predefined filters to a report, which lets them filter down or drill down into specific data subsets. This is an amazing feature to highlight the available data subsets for the users to extract actionable insights from the report. For example, you might have a social media report breaking down into Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, TikTok, and so on. So you might want to have like a buttons for Instagram, a button for TikTok, a button for Pinterest, and so on, so that the users can easily switch between the different data subsets and get the results that they want. So in today's tutorial, I'm going to cover how to create a simple button and then make that button work with the calculated fill. This is a very important thing that we must do in order to get the filter working. So here we're going to write the expression for the filters, and we're going to start with the easiest one, which consists of only one condition, and then we're going to move on to multiple conditions. So if you're ready, let's start. Adding a button in Lucas Studio is a breeze. You'll find the option in the same place where we usually add a control. So now you can just click add a control and you'll find the option button at the very bottom of the menu. Then you can click to add the button. Next, let's configure the button properties. So at the right hand side, you can see the button properties which we have set up that contains the settings, and then we have the style for the formatting and styling of your button. Now let's change the button action type from navigation to filter. For our purposes today, we're going to just focus on the filter option here, where we also have navigation and report actions available, but we're not going to cover it today. So just make sure you change it to filter. And you might notice that after you have changed to filter, there is a new property here, which is the control fill. And this is what makes the filter working, because as you can see here now, the button has turned into an error message. So now you will need to add a control fill here in order for it to work. Now to do this, we will need to add a calculated fill that returns a Boolean value. So what's happened here is Lucas Studio will, based on the expression that you write in the control field, it will evaluate each row to determine if it meets the condition defined by this button expression. So let me just add a chart so you can see what is the underlying data available here. So I have dates and I have platforms. You can just ignore other fields and let's do the comments as the metric. So essentially, this is the underlying data that we have. Just sort it to the date. So what I mean just now is that based on the filter option, Lucas Studio will check every row and see if it fulfills the condition. So say for example, if we write the expression where the platform is Pinterest. So now for the row one, Data Studio will return a true value for row number one. And then for row number two, because it's not Pinterest, it's going to return false. And then the third row will be false as well. And then the fourth row will be true. So based on the true and false, Lucas Studio will just extract the row that has true values. So to configure that, we're going to click on the calculated fill, and at the setup tab, go to the control fill and click add a control fill. Now a new window will appear and you can click on create fill to define the formula. Here we can insert a Boolean expression like, for example, platform equals
equals to the value Pinterest. So the name of the field, I'm just going to name it as Pinterest and click apply. And one more thing, because Looker Studio is case sensitive, so do make sure that the value of the condition is exactly matched with what is in the data set. For example, if it's capital P, you should start with capital P and so on. My suggestion is that you always create a simple table like this when you create calculated field so that you can refer to it directly. Once we have the expression set up, we can label the button by clicking on it and just key in the value just like how you usually edit a text box.
Before we move on, let's switch to view mode and test the button.
So now click on Pinterest and you should see all the values of Pinterest appearing in the tables below, and Instagram and the other platform will be filtered out. And you click it again, it will deselect the filter. So very, very cool.
However, sometimes you might need a button to filter multiple conditions. For instance, let's say you use Instagram as the main platform and you have two more sub-channels, which is TikTok and Pinterest. In this case, you can have two options. One is you create one individual button for each platform, and another option is that you can have one for Instagram and one for others, which group all other sub-channels that you have. You have to write a formula to evaluate multiple filter conditions. So let's move on to Looker Studio to learn how to do that.
So first of all, I'm going to click on the button that I created just now. Hit Ctrl C to copy and then hit Ctrl V to paste. You can also use Command C or Command V if you're using a Mac. Then we're going to go to the control field and click this icon here, effects, and it will open up the window for you to edit the formula. Now we're going to add or logical expression and followed by platform equals to TikTok, which is our second condition. So this is the first condition and this is the second, and we're going to combine them using OR logical expression. And now we can click apply. Let me just change the name of the field. Right after that, we're going to click on the button to change. So the first one, I'm going to change it to Instagram. And I'm going to change the name of it. If I click to filter Instagram, it's going to give all the Instagram values. And if I click others, it's going to give me none of the data. This is because that when you are selecting both buttons, it tells the Looker Studio to check both conditions. So it's going to check whether the value is Instagram and the values is one of the Pinterest or TikTok. Since each row can only have one platform, so none of the rows will actually fulfill the conditions that we have selected. So in this situation, these conditions are known as mutually exclusive. So the concept of mutually exclusive means that two things or ideas cannot happen or coexist at the same time. So it's like saying that you can either choose to go to the park or stay at home, and you can't do both activities simultaneously. So for example, for our data just now, it can only be one of Instagram, TikTok, or Pinterest. You can't have both. With that in mind, let's switch back to what we have just now. To avoid such issues, we'll have to put both buttons under the same group. This will make sure that when we select one button in the group, another button will be automatically deselect. Let's click edit and we're going to click on Instagram button. And here you can see under the control field, there's one button filter group. And by default, it's selected as none. Now we're going to select it to group one. For others, we're going to select it to group one as well. Now, let's go to view mode and click Instagram. This is just like how it behaved previously. And now we're going to click on others. You can see that now when I click others, Instagram button will be deselected and this will work perfectly. Now that's all for our tutorials today. I hope this clarifies how to use filter button, because when I first tried to use it, it's so confusing. So I hope this is helpful and get you started to start using this amazing feature for your dashboard. By the way, let me know if you want me to cover in more detail about the grouping of buttons in Lurker Studio, or if you want me to cover other aspects of this button control, leave your comments below and I'll look into it. Anyhow, I will put the links back to the official documentation if you want to explore more about this feature. So that's all for today. I hope you enjoy. Thank you so much for always supporting my channel, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye.